only in theaters September 8th. Rated R. Alexa Grasso is 30. Valentina Shevchenko, 35. Both women 5'5" tall. No issues on the scale. Slight reach advantage for Valentina Shevchenko. Tail the Tape, brought to you by Mortal Kombat. Now for the intros. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Chairman Dallas Hahn, Executive Director Jeff Mullen. Our three judges scoring this contest from Octagon side are Mike Bell, Zali Amato, and Junichiro Kamijo. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Herb Dean. And now, for those in attendance and UFC fans watching around the world, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC flyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding professional record, 23 wins, 4 losses. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in at 124.5 pounds. Fighting out of Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan, presenting the former UFC flyweight champion and the number one ranked UFC flyweight contender in the world, the challenger, Valentina Shevchenko! And now, introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist holding professional record, 16 wins, 3 losses. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in at 124.5 pounds, fighting out of Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world,
over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We're going to keep this clean. Touch gloves. Let's do it.
Mortal Kombat 1 available September 19th, rated M for mature. The atmosphere inside this T-Mobile arena is absolutely insane. You take those cans off for a second? My gosh.
You take them off, it's so loud. It's amazing how much noise these things cancel out.
Ready.
It's unreal.
Fight.
This fight clock is brought to you by New Amsterdam Vodka. Valentina Shevchenko in white, Alexa Grasso in the black and gold, befitting a champion. Body kick for Shevchenko is there early.
You see, right off the bat, we saw Grasso come out southpaw in the first fight. She comes out conventional in this fight.
And you saw Valentina right away dig that body shot. It is one of her best attacks, that kick to the body. She used it to set up the high kick. Now, the one reason you can't be overly aggressive against Shevchenko is because she has a tremendous counter right hook. She can hit it going forward. She can land on you whenever she's backing up. And she still possesses tremendous power.
Good left-hand connection, or so it appeared, by Shevchenko.
She's looking for elbows now, Anik. We're seeing the difference. She's got that back leg kick that she's looking for, and then when you see Grasso trying to come into the pocket, she's looking for elbows.
And a more aggressive Valentina Shevchenko. She's thrown that left, that right hook left hand two times already. Two big body kicks landed.
It has been a long 6 months for the former champion. Quick left from Grasso missed.
A lot of times you see fighters talk like they're gonna do things so different when they get back in the octagon, but then they don't show it. Shevchenko seems intent to deliver on all that she's promised this week.
And now we see Grasso in the southpaw stance. She switched.
She found a lot of success in this stance last time.
Shevchenko able to land a left on the end of that combination. Grasso now lands.
And the stance switch out of Grasso has taken away that back leg kick of Shevchenko that she was able to land very fast. Now that she switched stance, that kick isn't there, and it forces Shevchenko to adjust, start using that jab again.
There was a nice left hand in tight that Alexa Grasso landed that the former champion did not like. You see her blink a couple times, kind of reset herself. After Alexa Grasso landed a nice, dirty boxing left hand over the top.
That's that jab that she was able to really get off early in the fight, their first fight, in that southpaw stance.
Grasso saw that shot come, a nice elbow from Shevchenko.
And it wasn't until round three in fight one where Alexa was able to defend as good as she just did there.
Nice jab, won that jab.
It's so weird watching Alexa Grasso throw with Valentina and thinking that when they trade jabs, Alexa's jab is the one that does more damage.
Grasso keeping that guard tight, under 2 minutes here to go in round one of a possible five to decide the women's flyweight title. Through that time for the former champ.
You saw Valentina step there, looked like she was gonna try to spin.
She's looking for that hook. And the hook sets up that spin attack.
Look for Valentina to start tripping here.
Nice takedown. Double underhook body lock straight to the half guard.
She literally just turned her around and eventually Alexa got lost. You know, I figured in this fight, Alexa would be more prepared for the double leg, the single leg. I did not know if she could make the improvements to defend the clinch takedowns that Valentina was so successful with in fight number one.
That's why one of the keys I showed for Grasso is she has to be able to get up from these positions without giving up the position. Right now we're seeing she's got the back taken. We'll see if Valentina can transition and finish this.
Wow. She got high.
In the scramble. And that's what we saw.
The body by Shevchenko, but beautifully defended by the Mexican Grasso.
And that's what I said is going to be one of the keys through the whole fight, is if Grasso can create the space after she does get taken down. She got taken down in the last fight, but if you watch in her results in past fights, she always separates, creates the backup to the defeat scenarios.
She got taken down in fight one and got control in fight one, and I think that's the issue. She cannot get controlled in this fight if she wants to retain her championship.
All right, Valentina Shevchenko with a takedown, but a competitive round one. Back with round two in 30 seconds.
It's the same plan. The same plan is always is try to get a hard by and then start shaking, putting some feints in there and
check
start hitting
some
her low.
Replays. Look at this back leg kick from Shevchenko straight to the liver. Grasso ate that like nothing. She ate a couple of those, by the way. Nice jab from Grasso, and then they trade, and then look at this tight waist body lock takedown here. Just twisted her up, got her feet out from underneath her, and got that beautiful takedown. First round is hard to judge, but looked like it could have gone to Shevchenko if you had to guess.
Significant strike numbers, exceedingly close after round one. Here we go, round two.
That takedown by Valentina. The first one was defended. The second one, when she was able to get to the body, she was able to complete fairly easy. So it leads you to believe that she's going to go there again. You just wonder how soon she's going to try as Alexa lands a nice combo.
Right after this main event, They'll recap all the action on the Noche UFC post-show on ESPN+. Anthony Smith, Dean Thomas joining Karen Bryan up there to break it all down. Megan on standby. She'll interview all the big winners. You can see it right after this fight on E+.
Great defense there by Alexa. Valentina went back to that same deal. She tried to turn her around and take her down, but Alexa found the fence.
Well, that's also what makes Valentina the champion she is. When you start to let combinations go, she clinches you up and grabs you. That's exactly what you got to do sometimes. Just moving and backing up doesn't always work. You got to grab a hold of your opponent, get him to stop hitting you.
Well, we have seen Valentina fight in so many different styles, right? We have always seen her have tremendous striking, but in the Jessica Andrade fight, she was just wrestling to dominate her on the ground. We have seen her do a tremendous job of controlling women on the mat.
Oh, Russell!
Nice. Tight waist again. Body lock is deep. Let's see if she can finish it. That is tight. That's a bear hug, you call that.
Yeah,
she gets out.
Russell did a great job re-gripping the lock. And that right there is why Valentina wrestles Alexa Grasso so much.
The power in her hand. She feels it.
Oh, a nice knee to the body.
Oh.
Shevchenko may be in trouble here. Only round two.
Oh, my goodness. She's hurt.
Oh, and now Shevchenko lands an elbow. Space won't be Grasso's friend.
No, Grasso's corner's telling her to calm down.
This is not a territory that Shevchenko's used to being in either. Nice double.
Oh, nice double.
Beautiful timing.
Great timing there by the former champion.
That's smart. That was exactly what she needed. Exactly what she needed.
And it was because Grasso got excited. She takes her time. We've seen her defend Valentina's takedown.
She squared up and that allowed the double. Right here, she's just trying to get the air out of Shevchenko. It's not real. There's no submission here.
She's just a stall. Stands her up.
Yep. There's nothing here.
Shevchenko showing off her championship medal and instincts to take this fight down. There's the right hand that floored Shevchenko. Still just over 2 minutes here, round two.
And they both traded, they both connected. Just that you're seeing the power difference with Grasso.
We have seen Alexa Grasso just mature over the course of her UFC career. For a long time, she was killing herself to get down to 115, but the moment she went to 125, she was a completely different fighter, and now she finds herself the champion. Granted, this isn't great, right? But if she can limit the damage, that knockdown will really serve her well as we get to the end of the round.
Yeah, that knockdown's the round, at least right now, under 90 seconds to go. A kick from Grasso. Well, these women certainly bringing out the best in each other.
In a much more aggressive fight by both.
Oh, yeah, there's way more tension here in this matchup. And she just missed that.
Well, axe kick there.
Grasso so comfortable as a grappler off of her back. Diego Lopez certainly deserves a lot of credit. Good left hand for Shevchenko. Grasso also realizing success. Nice to have a referee who is allowing the fighters to work. Grasso tried to control posture for much of this latter part of the round, but Shevchenko stayed active.
Yes, she did, got control. But that up kick by Grasso was nasty. But then, even if Valentina loses this round, this is exactly what she needed. She needs to reset the fight because Alexa Grasso is starting to build momentum.
We got a title fight, folks.
Don't come close to the distance that you're not supposed to work on. She's relaxing you. Why are you doing this? She's not feeling well. Remember this. But don't relax. You understand? Do you understand? Do not relax.
Вот такое просто на обмене один удар и получается как бы чуть-чуть. А так все остальное просто смотри за ее ударом, четко перебивайся.
Keep watching her punches and punch yourself. You punch her. Just keep the distance. Work on your distance. And also throw her. You can throw her.
Right here you see Alexa Grasso land a beautiful right hand that drops Valentina Shevchenko. And it was the third punch. It wasn't the first punch. And it was a lot of good dirty boxing in close. Then the former champion lands a nasty elbow. Then that level change into the double leg, which allowed for her to control the rest of the round.
And such an urgent, immediate response from Shevchenko after the knockdown. Not enough, though, to win that second round. Here we go at the beginning of round three. Grasso, the slight favorite on the live number.
But you see Grasso go back to conventional, look for Valentina to start to throw that body kick again.
Oh, yeah, she's looking for it right now. That's her. That's how she finds her range, Valentina. She lands that kick and then starts getting to work from there. But the stance switch, you could tell, it kind of offsets the rhythm, the timing.
Inside leg kick lands cleanly for Shevchenko. Grasso corner calling for more feints out of her. Is that bruising underneath her right knee?
Oh yeah, she's taking quite a few kicks. That's a tattoo.
I thought it was a tattoo, yeah. But who knows? Either good way, job. You don't want to kick somebody in the knee. It doesn't feel good on your foot.
I mean, just the difference in the jabs.
Grasso trying to cut an angle here.
She drove her feet, she didn't stop on her knees, and she turned the corner. I mean, that's exactly how you finish a double leg. Drive your feet, turn the corner, perfect.
Grasso had an underhook. She was able to get her hands between Shevchenko and her legs.
Nice job.
Guillotine.
Straight to mount.
It's mounted.
It's not all it does. Ooh, that's tight.
That's tight.
That is tight. Wow.
Mounted guillotine for Shevchenko.
That is deep.
Grasso trying to survive.
Grasso's got to keep attacking that lock.
It's not over yet, but it is tight.
It's tight.
And Herb Dean is one of the best. You'll see, he's not panicking. You see how calm he is. He knows what he sees here. He's not jumping in there, not lifting arms, just watching.
Grasso's trying to stay relaxed in here, not panicking.
And these are the positions you're hoping from the bottom that Shevchenko's arms burn out before your blood choke kicks in. This is the battle.
And look,
there it is. That's what you're hoping to win. And that's what these guys are looking for in these positions. Great reffing.
That was great by Herb Dean. Didn't rush, didn't panic.
And a great job by Grasso to stay composed.
She never looked lost in there.
Peaceful. 2 minutes to go in round three.
She's got the foot on the floor now. That's exactly what she's got to do with that lock to get out of this body triangle. See how that foot is on the floor of Shevchenko. Yep. She wants to step over the top of that lead leg of Shevchenko, which she has. Start cranking on that ankle. And then slide her back to the mat. Grasso wants to get her head and her right shoulder flat on the mat. Now she's turning her hip down. She wants to go the other way. There, like that.
Oh, masterful job by Shevchenko, preventing her from doing just that.
But Grasso's got to try to slip a shoulder. Like, if she could slip her left shoulder out, then she can start to pull the left arm back and come around the waist of Valentina. But boy, Valentina is doing a great job of keeping that body triangle on.
So nice. A great job. It shows how strong and flexible Shevchenko's legs are, because Grasso did the right things and just too strong and flexible there.
Under a minute now to go in round three. Shevchenko in total control of this round thus far.
Like, look how Shevchenko's right leg is on the floor. Usually you can get out of that body triangle here, but because her legs are so flexible, it's not working. That's the right defense for Grasso.
Kicking her right foot behind the knee of Grasso. Grasso needs to try to clear that.
Needs to get underneath it.
Yes, she's got to find a way to clear that.
She's going the wrong way.
Well, she's trying to just twist. But Valentina's just controlling. She's not allowing for the body triangle to break.
Yeah, you got to go the other way.
Well, she'll end up on top now.
Now she got it. She pulled that shoulder out. You got to get that arm in between you, and now she's done it. And she'll end up on top at the end of the round. Armbar transition here if she wants. For Shevchenko. There it is. Great finish to the round.
Big round three, though, for the former champ.
Excellent move.
Excellent. 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 Sit down. Is he okay? I said, I want to breathe deep to your nose. This is, listen, breathe deep to your nose. Listen, I want you here. Breathe deep. Listen, it's 2-1. It's 2-1. It's really tight. Listen, you have to keep boxing. You have to go aggressive again. Okay. This we
need to don't miss her punches. She's catching them. Do not let go of her. Do not let go of your position. Two more rounds. Do not let her take it. You got to hold it. You got to hold her with your spirit. Don't let her go. Don't come close to her. You understand? She's relaxing you. Don't get close to her.
All right, next Saturday, top 10 lightweight square off inside the UFC Apex. The main event pits dazzling striker Rafael Fiziev against well-rounded Polish marauder Mateusz Gamrot. Main card, 7 p.m. Eastern next Saturday on ESPN+. All right, so going into the fourth round of their previous fight in March, D.C., Shevchenko led it 2-1. Is that how you see it thus far?
Yeah, I feel like it's 2-1 now. Round 1 and 3 to Shevchenko, round 2 to the champion Grasso. But this is where Grasso's got to be very careful in her approach. She cannot get reckless and get taken down early in this round. But that body triangle and that squeeze that Valentina held on to, that doesn't come for free. So the legs get a little heavy. You start to get a little tired as you're hanging on to that body triangle the way that Valentina did.
Inside leg kick for Grasso, who appears to just be in tremendous shape. Nice jab from the former champion.
This is how she won the first round, second round in their fight. Now in this fourth round, she's getting ahead on that jab again. Southpaw stance only. Remember, the jab's not there if you're conventional versus southpaw. Not the same way. They're in a jab war right now because they're in the similar stance, both southpaws.
Grasso corner, calling for more activity, especially when it comes to her boxing. Coach Dean Thomas, what do you have, sir?
Grasso's having a little hard time with the range here. She seems to be coming up short with her punches. And then she also has a dilemma because when she steps forward, she opens herself up to getting taken down. So the reality is what she has to do, she has to bend her knees a little bit more, keep stepping forward and throwing punches. Then she can find her range.
She ate a couple shots trying to get inside there. Shevchenko has landed 54% of her significant strikes thus far. 42% for Grasso.
Nice double. Great spell. See what she can do with this front headlock.
Hey, the hands up.
Yep.
Yeah, she was moving her back. So those were legal because she was dragging her backwards and the hand was coming up while she was moving. You can't touch the hand on the floor to stop them from kneeing you. You have to have weight on the hand in order for it to be a good stop.
Big knee to the body by Grasso. Shevchenko briefly protested those knees to the head.
The refs tell you in the back, you have to have weight on the hand. Oh, she scrambles. She's got an armbar transition here that she can transition from the Kimura.
She can
take the back or go to the arm.
She got excited, Dom.
Yep, Grasso.
Mistake by Grasso. Yep. Getting excited. Rushed to try to take the back of Shevchenko and lost the position.
This is
on the way back to her feet.
And replay did confirm that all of those strikes were legal. One hand down does not constitute a grounded opponent here under the guise of the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Good elbow from Shevchenko. Anybody's round seemingly under 2 minutes to go, and that one opened up a cut.
It's a good round to this point for the champion. She was able to land, got that nice takedown off, landed some good jabs. Valentina's got a hit. Land a few more strikes if she wants to get herself back into this round or win this round.
Oh, nice jab again.
Grasso has found some good success with that outside leg kick. Shevchenko's jab has been on point tonight.
Grasso's got to get back to the volume game. 1 minute to go, round four. Oh, beautiful combination. And the right lands for Shevchenko. She has been sharp from the outset.
Down on the trip. Yep.
Yes, so nice. That's what, four of those, just like that.
Yep, but she kept the wizard this time, Dom.
This is what Grasso has done so well, though, is just escape. She'll let you have a takedown, but this is, she's so hard to hold down and keep there. Other than that round, that Shevchenko is able to get that body triangle.
She's done a better job this fight getting up. Oh, she goes deep up.
Goes to
ankle lock. Yep.
Heel hook's locked in. That's threatening. That's a dangerous situation right here for Shevchenko.
The 20 minutes down. And the champion may very well need a finish to retain her title.
I need water. I need water. You have to stand. You have to withstand this. You cannot get tired. You have to keep moving. Do not stand on a distance where she can reach you. Just don't be in her distance and keep throwing her. Do not get caught by her. Do not get caught with her knee. Just keep holding her. She's waiting for your throw. Just be careful. You see how she's trying to go in? Just don't think of any, don't allow any mistakes. You have to be, you have to pull this out. You have to be smarter than her. I would smart her.
Fifth and final round to decide the UFC Women's Flyweight Championship. Round four, Dom, closer than round three. What'd you guys think of round four?
Oh, it comes down to this round right here.
Yeah, I believe so. I thought that the knees that Grasso landed, those big knees, she landed the big takedown, didn't give up much position when she got taken down. I think it's 2-2.
Yeah, I think it's up to this round right here. Who wants it more?
All right, 5 minutes to go. An early right hand lands for Grasso. Shevchenko 4-for-6 on her takedowns thus far. Beautiful jab.
Yeah, that jab has been nice tonight for Valentina. She's done a really good job of popping that jab, and then when Alexa gets close, she takes her down.
Oh, both fighters landed there. But a punctuating elbow for Shevchenko.
Big cut, big takedown, or big knockdown wins the fight, I think, here. Any of those three things.
Or if Valentina can get a takedown and control her. But she has to get some damage off. Now, that jab is nasty. And it's landed all night long. You said in the beginning, Dom, Alexa said she worked on her defenses to make sure she didn't get control with the jab again. Valentina has found a hole for that jab all night.
Well, that's the adjustment she had to make. Grasso said, I have to make that adjustment. Right now, she did early, but later on in the rounds, Shevchenko's been able to get off with that jab again.
Again, another good combination from Shevchenko. Low leg kick is there for Grasso.
Thank you.
Grasso advances with the jab after landing a leg kick. Not much in terms of combinations, though, here late.
Here in the Grasso corner, they want more activity. And she's going to have more activity if she wants to win this round and give herself a chance to retain.
Beautiful stick and move by Shevchenko.
Yeah, she's just a little lighter on her feet, yeah. Shevchenko. Just a little lighter, a little quicker,
jab
and getting
six.
Off a little bit more combos. Mostly the jab, though.
Grasso corner getting progressively more urgent. They need her to get inside.
Well, you see Shevchenko ready to level change the moment Grasso attacks.
Nice three-punch combo there.
Yeah, Shevchenko's fighting a beautiful round.
Yeah, this is a good round right here.
And Grasso is wearing it. A lot of that damage inflicted by that Shevchenko jab. Grasso back to the orthodox stance. Looping right hand offering from the champion. It does not land. 2 minutes now to go.
And
ooh, nice right hook there.
Valentina has lived in these moments, right? Fifth round of title fights, and it's showing in round five.
I think we're going to see Grasso step into the pocket at the end of this round. Nice read by Shevchenko.
Oh!
Gives it back again.
Oh!
Went for a headlock and gave her back. Let's
now
see if she can get out of
everything.
This. If she can escape, but right now she's giving it up. If she doesn't get moving.
This changes everything.
Wow.
And Valentina has to make sure
wow.
She doesn't have memories of last time.
Grasso pounding away, Shevchenko covering up.
Body triangle locked in.
Oh,
choke
my goodness.
Sunk in.
Oh,
choke
my goodness.
Choke is sunk in again.
Grasso might do it again.
Wow.
You can't see the lock under there. What a moment for the champion.
Wow. Shevchenko's out.
I mean, if she can hold this the rest of the round, she wins this round, more than likely.
Watch the back of the head.
Oh my goodness.
Bonnie Chang go for Grasso here. Final 30 seconds. What an absolute war between the two best flyweights in the world.
All the way to the very last second. They've been scrapping it out.
Yep. What a fight.
Late crank attempt here by Grasso. What a fight to put a capstone on the inaugural Noche UFC. Alexa Grasso and Valentina Shevchenko go the 25-minute championship distance here in Las Vegas. Their lives, professionally speaking, forever linked.
That's for sure.
Perhaps this series does not end here.
But it just shows, right, how competitive these two are. And I believe that we could match them up as many times as we want, and we would still see these types of fights every time.
This shows you just how world-class Guadalajara's Alexa Grasso is. Going toe-to-toe over five hard with the former queen, Valentina
Shevchenko.
Look at
this back leg kick from Shevchenko early on in the fight. Grasso was able to eat that like nothing and just keep going. Nice double leg. I mean, look, drives through, timed it perfectly. The 1-2s, and it was early on Shevchenko, but this fight went back and forth. Nice elbow for Shevchenko. And the jab all night. I mean, that was beautiful with the jab, but Grasso, man, the way that she also was able to floor Shevchenko, the heavy hand that she possesses, it made a difference with every strike. Significant strikes landed is very, very close. And you can see Grasso landed a ton of right hands as well. And the takedowns, the back and forth takedown battle between these two, epic. The body triangles, the way they were switching it up. Look at this headlock attempt from Shevchenko and the counter from Grasso to get that arm out of there at the last second and switch the roles, take the back, throwing that body triangle there in that quick scramble. Shevchenko unable to get away, and that's how the fight ended right there.
Valentina Shevchenko believes she has done enough to regain the flyweight throne. Alexa Grasso trying to put the ultimate finishing touch on this special UFC Fight Night Noche UFC. I see Bruce Buffer deliberating.
Let's get him in, Herb.
So first meeting between these two women at UFC 285 ended with a face crank in round four as Alexa Grasso ended the reign of Shevchenko that included seven title defenses. And now we'll see who did enough to win the rematch with the decision. Here's Bruce.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. Junichiro Kamijo scores the contest 48-47. Grasso. Saldi Amato scores it 48-47. Shevchenko. And Mike Bell scores the contest 47-47. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is considered a split draw. And still, the undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world, Alexa Grasso.
You can't touch this. Touch this. You can't touch this.